It seemed appropriate to end this season with a time of growth. Time really does not stand still. We are always learning and adding skills. And the end of our season is a beginning too, with a really fun planter project. Now, what you'll need to start is some kind of planter or pot or something like that. I have these really cute succulents, and I have a secret about them, which is they're not real. So this is totally fine. There's no dirt. They're not sharp. Nothing's gonna happen. But if you did have a real plant, you'd wanna make sure to take it out before you did any of this. Because what we're gonna do is we're gonna take what you might think is complicated and break it down into really easy steps. So what I've done is on these pieces of paper, I'm just gonna show you the steps first and then we're gonna do it, which is you can just take some very simple shapes to build a flower. And you can also take some simple shapes and build this sort of incredible vine. You can see how much more complex it gets. But trust me when I say it's easy. So I'm gonna be working with some gold paint pens. And all I'm gonna do is just shake them up to get them activated, test them out on a piece of paper. And when everything looks good, I'm gonna go ahead and start my first flower. So it is just a circle, and then I'm gonna add a petal, always going opposite. Opposites are the key here. Then I'm gonna do opposite again, and then we just go kitty corner opposite, but you can see how easy that is. And then I just color it all in, just like that. And you can see that without much effort, I now have my flower on there. Now, I do like to work holding the pot in all different directions because I find that if you hold it in one single orientation, what happens is you start to get attached to it being a certain way. And I think that most art that's 3D like this looks a little bit nicer when you take your time to sort of make it around. And I can just color that in. Now, sometimes I can find, especially with a small piece like this, that this tip is a little bit large for me. So then I'm gonna go ahead, grab a smaller tip, test that out, and then I can add all kinds of details, like let's say a curlicue vine. And as I work around this pot, I just simply turn it. You can see why it's important this is a fake, because I'm hanging on to it. And I can just go ahead and go onto it and add that leaf. Now this dries pretty quickly, so I don't have to worry too much about it, but I'm not gonna just, you know, right after I paint it, work it around. I kind of work one side to the next instead of just flipping it over immediately to the opposite. I'm also working on top of a brown piece of paper in case I do get any ink, then I don't get it on my table. So what is a leaf shape? It's literally just a little teardrop like this. Couldn't be more simple. And if I don't have enough room for a leaf, one of the things I can add that makes a design look complicated but isn't is a small curlicue. Now, this is the secret to everything I do, which is it's not that any of these items are such spectacular drawings, but when you start to add them all up, when you start to get a bunch of them, it starts to look incredibly impressive and like you really know how to draw. And the good news is you don't have to know how to draw at all. You're just having fun relaxing and doodling. And even look at how I am coloring these in. They're not colored in all the way. They're just colored in a little bit. They're not totally perfect. They're just a touch, but because it's gold, it's gonna draw the eye. Recently, I was actually in Ireland and we were touring some old churches, and the first thing that I noticed is there were many places where there was gold and it immediately drew your eye in these dark spaces. And the same thing is true of picture frames in art museums. When you look, they're often gilded and it's to bring attention to what's in there. Okay, can you see how cool this vine is? And all it is a couple swirls and some badly colored in leaves, and it's totally fine. Now, if you want another detail that I like to add, and I take advantage actually of the different tip sizes, okay, because I've got a really big and a really small, I'm just gonna draw dots. And that's literally just dropping the dots. But when you vary the size of them, it makes them have so much more impact. And there's a real rhythm there, because you can you see how tiny the second set of dots are compared to the first set. It kind of does what I like with paint, with the paint splats, where they seem to just give a little bit of shine and sparkle everywhere. So there you go. You can take your time with this. This is a great thing to do with kids. They can certainly design their own pieces. Now, if botanicals like this are not necessarily your thing, okay, and you're more of a contemporary person, well, you can do an easy contemporary design. So let me show you how easy this is. I'm gonna do fat lines all the way down. And I just call them fat because I'm using this thicker tip marker. Okay, and then I'm gonna take the thinner one and do thin lines. And you can see it couldn't be easier. The lines aren't straight, they aren't perfect, they aren't any of those things. But what they are is they have a lot of rhythm because again, I'm repeating the same shape over and over, the same color, and I might add just one more up here to kind of fill that space. And if this isn't your thing, don't worry, I've got another idea for you. So this I think is probably one of my favorite patterns that I draw, and it couldn't be more simple. It's just little notches, almost like you're making tick marks of some kind, but what it does, and especially with succulents I think, is it almost mimics the little needles on the cactus or the cacti, because you can really see how this then makes the succulent feel like it's in a pot of its own making. You could even put the name of the succulent on it. You could add something else to it. And you could play around too with other colors, although I love the simplicity of keeping it in the gold. So let's just take a peek at all the different sides that we've done here. So we started out, right, with some flowers. Then we moved into doing some vines and dots. We also did some stripes, and here are our tick marks. And if we look over at the finished ones, you can see all together, even though they have different styles, even though, right, this one is very fancy and intricate, and this one is very simple, it doesn't matter because they're all the same white pot with a little bit of a gold design on them. It brings everything together. You can really personalize your little pots, and you can use this technique for all sorts of other surfaces. So I hope you'll grab a gold marker and give it a try.